Goedenavond, welkom in IJsstadion Tilburg. Vanavond heb ik de gast Bo Subber, coach van Tilburg Trappers, en Mickey Bastings, de captain van Tilburg Trappers dit seizoen. Bo, I want to start with you. How are you doing?
Yeah, one of the big things is I'm healthy, family's healthy, the guys on the team, they're healthy corona-wise. We still have a lot of other injuries, but, aside from not winning enough, we're doing what we can. So, trying to get through the rough times.
Okay. Listen, before I started to do the interviews, I started to get some information. I tried to put a little bit of an image what the type of Bo Subber is, because I never met you in person before. So for me, it's also the first time. I read that you were in Eindhoven, you started in Holland. I think it was 2009, 2010,
I started in Amsterdam. That was,
as a player.
As a player. And then coaching, I started in Eindhoven. I was part of the CTO program back mm-hmm. then that was running. It was a great thing that the Federation had. Mm-hmm. And then, once the program was done, I applied for this job and was fortunate enough to get the job and to coach in a great organization like the Tilburg Trappers. And, very fortunate to have good teams every year I've been here, and great players around, and great personnel aside from the players. So, happy
must
to be here.
Must be, you must like it because you are now for the sixth season.
Yeah, of course. Like I said, it's a great organization. Mm-hmm. The group's been good. Obviously, we lost some players that have been here for a longer time. They're still, I think, they still had a lot of years left in them, but mm-hmm. they took a different path. My daughter's been growing up here. Now we have two daughters, so everything around the organization is good. And with the situation we're in right now, there's no rush to go anywhere else.
Okay. Mickey, bij jou, jij bent eigenlijk bij de jeugd opgegroeid. Ik denk net niet in die tijd dat ik nog coachte bij de jeugd. Ik denk dat jij dan aan de hand, want ik heb jou nooit in een team gehad bij mij.
Ja,
denk
ik heb wel nog trainingen meegedaan.
Trainingen wel,
hè? Een hoger team mee mocht doen. Jij ook coach, hè, inderdaad.
Nog net. En sindsdien is er natuurlijk heel veel gebeurd met jou, hè?
Sindsdien is er best veel gebeurd, ja.
Vertel eens, hoe is de ontwikkeling verder gegaan?
Ik denk dat ik een jaar of 12 was toen ik bij jou ook mee mocht trainen, denk ik. En toen was ook Mark de Hond en zo waren toen ook. Ik denk dat ik toen ik 15 was, ben ik naar Duitsland gegaan. Heb ik daar een maandje gezeten. Heb ik DNL gespeeld. Want toen woonde ik wel in een internaat en dat was niet echt mijn ding.
Van huis weg, hè?
Ja, van huis weg. Ik ben wel een familiemens, zeg maar. Dus ik wil graag mensen om me heen, vrienden om me heen. En gewoon een beetje een vertrouwde omgeving. Nu dat we het over vertrouwd hebben, ben ik het jaar daarna naar Canada gegaan. Was helemaal ver weg van thuis natuurlijk, maar daar was wel een bekende taal natuurlijk. Dus daar hielp wel mee. Ik werd daar beter geholpen als in Duitsland. In Duitsland werd ik eigenlijk gewoon een beetje aan mijn lotje overgelaten. En sprak iedereen gewoon Duits en deed niet echt iedereen
moeite
om een beetje kennis te maken of mij tenminste wegwijs te maken. En ben ik teruggekomen. Dat is nu 11 jaar geleden. Dus,
maar daar hebben natuurlijk wel een ervaring op gedaan.
Ja, zeker. Ja, dat was zo'n ervaring kan ik iedereen wel aanraden.
Mooi. Ja. Bo, de season ended last season crazy wise because of corona in March. And I find that nobody expected that it would be different in August. But tell me, you guys started in August. The players came together, you had to sign players, everything, get everything organized, and you didn't know that the competition was going to start.
Yeah, that was there was a lot of question marks, obviously, throughout the summer. Obviously, the way the season ended last year, it was unfortunate for us. We had all the guys getting healthy and ready for the playoffs to give it a good push. But there's something, there's things we can't control, and, there's things that happened, and the season was over. As far as the summer, that was a bit difficult, obviously, with the situation. Nobody knew what's going to be going on, mm-hmm. when the season can start. There's been a lot of discussions, and we had to try to build the team around in a certain ways, that's how it was. And we were on the ice from about middle of August, and everybody was hoping things were going to go well because the numbers were good in the summer, right? So everybody was hoping for the best, but the predictions and everybody getting back from vacations and traveling around, the numbers went up, and obviously the season started when it started, You know, it's if you look at the DL, they're still not playing, right? So there's other competitions that are, you know, that started early September. So it's all different. I think we're fortunate enough that we actually can play. You know, I think it's a big loss that you cannot have the fans, but at least there's the Sprout TV where everybody can watch it now. But it's been you know, quite different, and everybody's got to learn to work with the situation mm-hmm. and handle it in a different ways. You know, get used to play without the fans. For us, getting used to play on the road all the time for now mm-hmm. for the time being. Mm-hmm. So it's there's a lot of things to get going.
Mm-hmm. And another thing is that you. Now you don't play at home, but when Corona is finished, we hope in January or February maybe that you get a lot of home games maybe. If yeah. you, because I had that this coming weekend, you guys have an away game or a home game and
yeah, this like yesterday we had a game in Hanover that was it was our home game, but it was in Hanover, right? Yeah. So you travel almost 5 hours to get to your home game, so you know that's a bit difficult for the guys. They don't feel like we're playing a home game, and obviously all the kilometers we have put in over the last couple months, it's been a lot, and I think you know the guys can feel it. You know, you get a bit fatigued at times, mm-hmm. not just physically but also mentally from things. So you know, there's a lot of things that the guys have to learn to work with, and we got to get around to try to make sure we have you know everything mixed the proper way so they get enough rest but they still get enough trainings in a certain way so that is a bit difficult for the home games. Yeah, it'll be great mm-hmm. you know if everything works out the way it is and we can play home games from a couple weeks on, so we'll see and hope for the best.
Hopefully the vaccine gets pretty fast and the testers that get better, that people can go and watch the game. It should be a great yeah. for you guys. Eh?
Yeah, I think that's the first step for us is to be able to play at home.
Yeah.
To be able to use the dressing room like normal. You would be able to use before, because you know, hockey is a collective sport, and the way we have it now, you don't have the feeling. You don't feel like you have the great preparation for the mm-hmm. practice. You're limited of doing certain things in practice. So it all makes it a little bit of a little bit of a puzzle every time, and mm-hmm. And I think for the guys, for the group, it's a lot easier when you have the dressing, you can use it in a normal way, you can have your video sessions, you can have your pre-practice preparation the way you want to have it, the off-ice preparation, you know, with the situation we're in, we're used to having our off-ice sessions before practices, and the way it is now, the guys have to come in pretty much dressed, right? So it's pretty tough to go to the gym and then have your hockey equipment on, so there's a lot of tricky things that we have to get around with.
Mickey, hoe gaan jullie dan mee om als spelersgroep? Lijkt me verschrikkelijk moeilijk natuurlijk. Hè?
Ja.
In een andere situatie terechtkomt nou.
Ja, ik heb het boot allemaal wel een beetje even gezegd. Normaal komen we hier naartoe en dan op dinsdag dan hebben we met z'n allen off ice. Dan gaan we naar de gym of gaan trappen lopen of iets op de tribune. Mm-hmm. Hè, dat we van tevoren. En dan doen we gewoon onze normale training als een groep. En meestal is dinsdag wel wat zwaarder. Nou, nu moet je natuurlijk rekening houden met de afstand op het ijs, hè? Dus we willen niet te veel contact maken. Woensdag hebben we normaal gewoon video en dan doen we daar onze trainingen op aanpassen. Nou, dat is nu ook wat moeilijker, want ja, we hebben nu eigenlijk niet echt een plek waar we goed video kunnen doen. En donderdag is eigenlijk een beetje hetzelfde verhaal. Hè? Normaal hebben we ook gewoon een training waar we onze training eigenlijk afstemmen op de tegenstander. Maar omdat we nu niet zo goed contact mogen maken met elkaar en dan gaan we ook eigenlijk liever een beetje uit de weg, is allemaal een beetje anders.
Dat is moeilijk.
Het is wel moeilijk, ja.
Je kunt eigenlijk een wedstrijdssituatie kunt eigenlijk niet in uw training meer omgaan. Nee. Dat kan gewoon niet.
Nou ja, we doen eigenlijk een beetje, of tenminste Boot eigenlijk een beetje zijn best om ons allemaal fysiek gewoon klaar te stomen voor het weekend. En mm-hmm. Daarbij doen we wel oefeningen die zoveel mogelijk aansluiten op de tactieken die we willen voeren. Maar het is wel veel anders dan normaal. Ja.
En jullie trainen ook één keer met heel de groep in Duitsland, één keer in de week?
Ja, normaal.
Is dat niet meer?
Ja, normaal gesproken inderdaad, dan proberen we één keer in de week naar Duitsland te gaan, zodat we zeker die groeptraining hebben.
Ja, ja. En Bo, what do you do with the rest? You guys try to make the practice good for the guys that they have fun? Or?
Yeah, well, they have fun, yeah. And then, but you know what, we got to find, and we talk about it since the situation started, we got to try to make the best out of what we have, mm-hmm. you know, and I had actually a conversation with Mickey before the situation is it is now, and I was telling him, you know, we got to try to make sure we get the maximum out of every practice were allowed to have together, because, and then a few weeks after that, we were no longer allowed to practice as a full group or do the things we would normally do. So now either it's the little group trainings, we try to make sure, you know, we still get out of it what we want to have in the games, to have certain habits, mm-hmm. To work on some skills a little bit more, and to do different things. But like, you know, Mickey mentioned, is the physique part is mm-hmm. is a big part of hockey game, right?
Yep.
And
yep.
if you don't have that on the daily basis, it's you know, it's tough to all of a sudden come in the game and be right away you know, ready into it. And you can see that at times it takes us you know, a couple minutes or half a period to actually get into the certain game rhythms, yeah, and to yeah. be able to do certain things. Mm-hmm. So yeah, and the way we used to train, it's it was usually pretty tough Tuesdays, and we would do a lot of those things. And and now it's a bit more difficult to get things done like that. So we try to get creative, as creative mm-hmm. as we could be, and you know, hope for the best that sooner or later we can get back
to normal,
do normal things, and mm-hmm. And prepare the way we want to prepare.
Mm-hmm. And still, you guys watch a lot of the games from other teams, and you watch the videos, and
yeah,
to bring that over to the guys, and they can only be with two or three with you guys on desk or. But you do it with the team, you said, over here?
Yeah, we do like videos, like sometimes, because we, you know, when we have also have some morning practices with some smaller groups, so we'll go through some video with some mm-hmm. Younger guys in the morning. Because for them, it's really important to see what they do as well. And then we have the group video, you know, we'd like to do that once a week to go over really team things and you know, get up, try to figure out ways to try to maybe get a little bit more out of it. We did some little group video last week with the power plays, you know, where you can have enough space, and mm-hmm. So yeah, we gotta get creative with that. Obviously, Josh and I, we see a lot of the other games and try to see what the other teams do. Obviously, there's some new teams. We played some older teams, but they have some new coaches. Obviously, Scorpions change things around,
systems, and
so usually we know what to expect. I think, you know, big problem as right now is what we talked about, the physique and the physical part, where you have to do a lot of things under pressure in the game,
yeah.
And when you don't get to practice it in a regular basis, you kind of miss it a little bit, and I think that's a bit of part of our reason not to be able to score, because we get chances enough,
you know, yeah.
the guys they come in, whatever they do in practice, they work hard, and they you know, they show up in the games, and you know, when it's tough mentally for him, you know, in the situation everybody's in, especially if you don't win hockey games, you don't score any more chances, guys start to hold the sticks a little bit tighter and start to think, you know, change this, change that, and you know yourself how it goes with the hockey players, right? So it's sometimes it's frustrating to see, you know, how much effort the guys put in and what they get in return sometimes. So that's you know, pretty tough.
Thank you, Damien. Jij in de wedstrijd natuurlijk ook dat fysiek contact dat jullie eigenlijk minder training hebben als die buitenland, als de Duitse teams. Want de Duitse teams die trainen normaal, denk ik, standaard 4-5 keer in de week op.
Ja.
En die mogen dan wel fysiek contact hebben in de trainingen. Dus die komen beter geprepareerd aan de wedstrijd als jullie natuurlijk.
Ja, die hebben daar zeker een voordeel bij. Als je ziet, eigenlijk alle teams hebben ook wel gewoon een sportschooltje in de kleedkamer. Hè? Dus maar die mogen gewoon overal gebruik van maken daar. Dus daar is denk ik zeker wel een voordeel. En ja, wij worden daar toch wel een beetje in geremd eigenlijk. Hè? Net als bij ons zijn, eigenlijk, wij zijn gewoon gewend om een bepaalde routine te doen, wat wij door het hele jaar doen. En dat kunnen we nu gewoon niet doen. Dus dat is gewoon frustrerend.
Frustrerend. Ja. Doen jullie ook, worden jullie ook getest op corona elke week, net als die voetballers? Of is dat een reis ook niet?
Nee, ja, eigenlijk is het nu tot nu toe zo gegaan, als iemand ergens last van heeft of zo, dan gewoon gelijk laten testen. Of gewoon, eigenlijk is het gewoon onze eigen verantwoordelijkheid. En je eigen verantwoordelijkheid nemen vooral. En als je ook maar een hoesje hebt of een snotneus, dan gewoon laten testen. En tegenwoordig kan je overal op de hoek een sneltest doen of iets dergelijks. En we hebben ook gewoon goed contact met de doktoren. En, dus ja, daar worden we wel een beetje aan gestuurd.
Dat is allemaal goed geregeld aan.
Ja.
Goed geregeld aan. How do you see for the coming months, Bo? Because nobody can say exactly what's going on and how we do it with the test and the vaccine. And what's your opinion about this whole situation?
Yeah, for me, you know, obviously, it's some things are frustrating, right? What you can have and cannot have, mm-hmm. you know, the decisions that, you know, we don't make, but the people at the higher positions make, what is allowed, what is not, where, you know, you have, you know, supportive team where everybody's serious with what they do, and they take precautions. They don't do things. They try to stay within line to make sure they don't get infected, and things are not allowed for that. And then we have things in a normal life that are allowed where mm-hmm. people just don't takes a lot of the rules as serious as they should, and then obviously the numbers stay up, so that's a bit frustrated. So I hope things will get better. Mm-hmm. Hopefully the vaccine will help, to bring the numbers down, and the life can go back to normal, or the new normal, as they say. Especially for us and for the sportive collectives such as youth clubs, they can mm-hmm. train, but they can't play games either. Yes. So it makes it tough on everybody. So I hope that within the vaccine and over the next couple of weeks, things will settle down a little bit and things can get to normal.
Yeah, on the other side, did you have one guy on the team yet until now who has Corona? Had Corona? Did you have one?
No.
So it means that you guys.
We. What we've been pretty strict since August. We had in the summer when no other teams were almost training. There was a couple teams in Germany to train. Guys would get in contact with somebody, and they would go to quarantine, and they would go get tested. And try to keep it pretty pretty separate from there. So
you guys are straight on.
Yeah,
we
have a couple of guys that have been tested four times, had to be in quarantine for four times, but they haven't had it. they missed because in the summer the quarantine was longer than it's now too.
Yeah.
So we have some guys that had to go through that procedure, but never had the Corona issue, and trying to be smart and respect the rules mm-hmm. and try to be safe. And
there's nobody in the organization or in the Dutch Ice Hockey Federation who can put the pressure on, because if you got a really different how shall I say this? The organization is different than other soccer teams or whatever, and you guys can prove the last month that there was no Corona. You cannot do the physical tactics or anything in the training, and you have to go to Germany to play that game. I think Tilburg is one of the teams who's way above the rest, and you still get. I cannot.
I think I think the organization's working and talking within the city, talking within the NOC, I think obviously talking with the federation, and hopefully somebody can make some decisions and give us an exception, because obviously mm-hmm. we're a lot different than a lot of the other teams, and we do play in a different country, so it's not that we're going over all the other Dutch teams. So that is a frustrating part as well, because we can play overboard, but we can't play here. That's and the way they give status to different teams, that's kind of professional sport is a professional sport, and for our guys, it's they make living out of that too, and it's a professional organization, and that's spends a lot of money on a lot mm-hmm. of things, and mm-hmm. you can do the things the way you want to, and you're used to. So it's a bit frustrating. So hopefully somebody can help, or know somebody to make decisions, or talk to the right people to get some changes done.
Yeah, for sure. That, because you told me that the women national team are practicing with the whole group over here, and they can do the practicing because they have the NOC status.
Yeah,
and I cannot.
Yeah, for it's great for them that they have the status. They they play. They still have to play an Olympic qualification somewhere down the road. If you look at it, that's an amateur sport.
Yeah.
None of them make any money for it, mm-hmm. or the girls that maybe do, they're outside of the country, so they're not taking part of these practices. I don't think, maybe at times they do, but not for all of them.
Mm-hmm.
And for our guys, I think it's a whole different level. We have majority of the guys from the men's national team or from the under 20 national team. We try to usually bring up a lot of our younger guys too. We have guys that are in the under 18 national team, and if he had things normal way, we could have him in and out, and try to help him to reach another level. And right now we cannot do those things, right? You don't, you're not allowed to practice with those numbers. So yeah, it makes it a little bit frustrating. Makes the sport to stay at a certain standstill with with where it is. So yeah, it's.
Okay, enough of Corona. Mickey, hoe is het seizoen tot nog toe? Het is natuurlijk een heel andere situatie, dat weten we allemaal. Maar goed, je bent aan het seizoen begonnen. De spelers, het meeste van de jongens waren allemaal hetzelfde als vorig jaar. Hè? Ja. Dus ik geloof dat één speler niet, Mitch Wuister was afgehaald. De rest is gewoon allemaal terug.
Ja, de rest is allemaal terug inderdaad.
Dus wat dat betreft is heel de club lekker bij elkaar gebleven.
Ja. Ja,
maar
ja,
dan krijg je natuurlijk dat, wanneer kunnen we beginnen? En dat was pas in november.
Ja.
Nou, dan beginnen we het seizoen.
Ja, dan beginnen we het seizoen, ja. We waren goed begonnen. Hè. De eerste wedstrijd wonnen we gelijk in Hannover. Mm-hmm. En we hadden een paar lange uitwedstrijden achter elkaar in een weekend. Uiteindelijk denk ik dat we goed waren begonnen in de eerste vier wedstrijden. En nu hebben we dan drie wedstrijden achter elkaar verloren. Mm-hmm. Iets teleurstellend, dan zie je dat het misschien een beetje op begint te breken. Maar goed.
Ik begrijp het verhaal van boven die video gezien heeft, dat het dus andere oorzaken heeft.
Ja, goed. Precies. Maar goed, we hebben wel gewoon de kansen om het wel af te maken. En het loopt nu misschien niet hoe dat we zouden willen, maar...
Klein beetje geluk.
Klein beetje geluk en ik heb wel gewoon vertrouwen in dat het wel goed gaat komen.
En reizen? Natuurlijk heel veel. In een kort tijdsbestek. Doe was corona niet vrij is, dan hoort met kerst en nujaar voor jullie ook een drukke periode, denk ik.
Ja, we hadden het er van tevoren al over. Vorig weekend hebben we 28 uur of 30 uur of zo in de bus gezeten. Ja, dat is best veel Netflixen, zeg maar. En er wordt alleen maar meer. Met kerstspel iets van 16 wedstrijden in 30 dagen of zo. Ja. En, normaal hebben we daar een paar thuiswedstrijden tussenin zitten en dan is het nog wel te doen. Nu is het nog maar afwachten. En, we zijn allemaal blij dat we natuurlijk mogen spelen en daar zijn we ook al op voorbereid. En we weten allemaal dat de situatie zo is, dus we moeten gewoon blijken hoe dat we het gaan doen. En we zijn er in ieder geval wel gewoon klaar voor en iedereen heeft gewoon die mindset erop zitten van het is nu eenmaal zo. En,
Hoe is de competitie vergeleken met vorig jaar of de vorige jaren? Is het sterker of zitten de teams dichter bij elkaar? Of?
Ja, je merkt wel dat Del is nou natuurlijk niet bezig. Er zijn heel veel spelers uit de Del die schuiven door naar Del 2. En er zijn spelers uit Del 2 die gaan door naar de Oberliga. Plus je ziet ook nog eens dat er heel veel imports natuurlijk vrijkomen uit Engeland en uit al die andere competities. En die zijn nu allemaal gewoon aangesloten bij onze competitie. En dan wordt de competitie wel serieus sterker van. Plus die worden allemaal aangevuld door talenten die wel zowel uit de U20 van Duitsland komen of de U19. Dus er zijn echt wel talenten die gewoon echt goed kunnen hockeyen. En je merkt gewoon de laatste paar seizoenen dat gewoon het niveau steeds hoger ligt. Waardoor je ziet dat elke wedstrijd is gewoon close. We hebben alleen in Herne met 7-1 gewonnen. Maar dat is echt een uitschieter, want we hebben ook gewoon echt een team.
Die maakt gewoon elk seizoen mee.
Ja, maar die hebben ook echt een team waarbij we gewoon van tevoren niet hadden verwacht dat die uitslag zo zou zijn. En daar scoorden wij in één keer wel heel veel en gewoon goede goals. En, dus ja, ook dat soort wedstrijden heb je erbij zitten. Maar over het algemeen zit het nu heel dicht bij elkaar.
En ik wou zeggen, die imports in Duitsland, hoeveel mogen ze per team eigenlijk hebben?
Twee.
Nou goed, oké. Ja, als ze dan met een heel arsenaal kunnen pikken en jullie mogen geen imports meebrengen, dan loopt het ook weer achteraan natuurlijk.
En voorheen kwamen de imports uit het derde niveau college in Amerika. En daarna kwamen ze uit het eerste niveau college en daarna American Hockey League. Maar nu zie je gewoon al NHL-gasten dat die gewoon al bij ons als import erbij komen. Ja, dat zijn toch al gasten die echt wel iets toevoegen aan een team en die echt wel het verschil kunnen maken. Het is alleen maar leuk voor ons, zeker.
Misschien in de Oberliga de organisatie moet terugdenken van dat Tilburg ook wat wel je in pas mag hebben.
Wie weet.
Gezien de situatie.
Het is voor ons alleen maar een uitdaging natuurlijk. Ja. En ook leuk om tegen dat soort gasten te spelen. Want daar kun je eigenlijk wel in meten van hoe sta je ervoor. En ook voor die jongere gasten leuker. En die gasten brengen toch een bepaalde soort mentaliteit of zo naar een bepaalde competitie. En, daardoor wordt het zeker beter.
Bo, you also working with the junior organization in Tilburg. How you see the future for them, for the kids? Are the talents coming up from say 12, 14? That's the age that you can.
Yeah, well, Josh, he's the main guy that works with the junior organization. Okay. That's he spends a lot of hours with the with the junior organization, and I help out with you know, some things. We got some skills trainings. We got some we got the top sport class and so on. So I usually go on the ice with that. Yeah, there's couple talents in every age group. So you know, there's over the years there should be some new guys coming into the team. So you know, hopefully, you know, if there's one or two guys that always leave over a couple of years, that mm-hmm. there could be you know, 2-3 new guys that can fill in the holes from within the organization. So that's one of the things off the club, you know, to try to work with the youth. That's you know, why Josh is involved quite a lot, and I'm there at times, and try to have that running to make sure there's local kids coming into the first team and having you know, that mentality of and having you know, the feel for the club and you know, having it in their heart you know, from growing up in the organization.
What they can reach and they can get that chair in the first team, and
and
as soon as they enter the dressing room, then it starts.
Yeah, you know, when a kid has a relation to the club, it's always you know, he always gives an extra. He always you know, has a different feel and a different perspective of playing for that team. Mm-hmm. So and it's been like that in Tilbury. There's been always a lot of Tilbury guys, and we still have a lot of Tilbury guys in the team, and I think that's the way it kind of should be, and every club kind of should work that way to make sure the youth organization is working well and bring their own talent.
How many practices do you have a week with the first team?
With the first team, we have 3 mandatory. Yeah. And we have 2 optional. So sometimes now with the changes we had, we had more. You know, we would have the morning and then afternoon. We have half of the guys in the morning, half in the afternoon, depending on the schedules with school or work. Mm-hmm. So it's been over the last couple of weeks, it's been you know, try to get creative with things. So but usually with the schedule, with the travel, we kind of figure out a certain plan. So it's anywhere between 3 to 4 mandatory practices and 2 optional ones, where we still get a lot of guys to show up for those. So that's what we do. And then, you know, aside of that, we usually have plans for the guys now to work out at home or work out in the gym before they come to practice or when they have the time. And, you know, we trust them with that. Like I said, we cannot do the team workouts like we used to do. And we did a lot of those at the start of the year, but you know, over time you see you know, the guys miss it as well. So yeah, it's within the travel, you know, like I said, you want to have a happy or good mix between you know, practicing hard and also having a rest for the guys, so you know, they don't burn out and they still have energy to play games. And it's usually a pretty long season, so try to make sure they get their rest as well.
And in those hours when you're on the ice, you do the technical skills. And the tactical skills you do on the group and in the bus, because you have hours.
Yeah, in the bus, that's you know, before the game, and then but in the bus, it gets pretty busy and pretty you know, it's not easy to do things on the bus there. So it's usually before the game, and you know, we do here. The good thing is we have a lot of guys that have been on the team for a long time, so a lot of things is the same.
Sometimes the same group.
We change some minor things at times with the different. Different, you know, forechecks or breakouts. It usually stays pretty close to what we got to do. It depends on different teams, how they forecheck, how they play. Just little adjustments to our setups. But that's you know, with the group we have, it should not be too difficult to do so.
That's a good thing.
Yeah, you know, I think with all around game, with the part when we're on the puck, you know, to break out of the zone, to get through the neutral zone regroups, that's not much of a problem. I think we still create a lot of chances off the rush, even in the offensive zone. We just, you know, there's little details, you know, getting to the net front, you know, winning those loose puck battles that you don't get to practice. That's where a little bit of an issue you see over time. So because you don't practice it, right? You keep your distance here and there, so the timing is off. You know, then you get in a battle. You got to battle through that, and the scoring chances under pressure, right?
That makes things
a little difficult. Like I said, we generated a lot of chances over the last 3 games, but we're not able to capitalize on pretty much all of them. So that's something you know, it goes with the confidence of the players too, right?
Yep.
If you're scoring, everything seems quite easy. And all of a sudden you don't score for a couple of games and you start to think a little different, you know, the mindset and the And the mental part is quite a big thing for sports, and you know, it's not just for hockey, it's for all the sports. If you look at tennis or golf, individual sports, but you know, in those two sports especially, if you start thinking a little different, the game could change quite quick. So it's
between the ears.
Yeah, you know, and I hope for our players. Sometimes it takes a lucky break for some players just to, you know, get on the other side, because they're getting chances, and hopefully we get those quite soon, because they've been working hard to get better and to be able to score and generate. So, you know, they're putting in the work in a certain way, right? So they should get the payout back with some goals and wins now. So
good luck. Mickey, de lijnen is een beetje hetzelfde als vorig jaar. Of zijn er lijnwisselingen gekomen? Of wisselingen veel van lijnen? Of?
Ja, er is al wel veranderd inderdaad. Ja, we proberen meestal, want we hebben nu een paar nieuwe spelers sinds vorig jaar dan. Hè. Diego Hofland is natuurlijk bij. Remo van der Schuit is natuurlijk bij. Ja, we proberen altijd een beetje, of tenminste, we proberen dan altijd een beetje te schuiven en te kijken wie het beste bij elkaar passen. En wie welke gaten het beste op kan vullen. En ik denk dat we het nu wel goed hebben gevonden, dat we elkaar wel goed aanvoelen.
Paul Pepin is natuurlijk ook een probleem, want je kunt niet altijd volle 100% op trainen.
Dat is natuurlijk wel ook een probleem daarvan, hè, omdat we natuurlijk hier in de trainingen moeten we in een bepaalde hokken blijven, hè, zo noemen wij het maar. En dus kunnen we daar niet echt op trainen. We hebben nu echt een paar keer opgetraind en dan zie je dat toch af en toe wel eens een vlucht afwerpt als je toch wel oefent. Ja, maar over het algemeen wel tevreden over
de
lijn.
Dan denk je de rest van de competitie, waar heb je een bepaald doel? Je wilt kampioen worden, dat is altijd natuurlijk. Ja. Maar wat denk je zelf? Kijk, ik zeg altijd als je maar bij de play-offs zit, nummer 1 kan ook van 6 verliezen, hè?
Ja, zeker weten. We hebben jaren bijgezeten dat we tweede werden en we zijn een keer vierde geworden. Maar ik ben niks anders gewend bij deze club dan dat we gewoon eerst worden. Ja. Wij doen niet echt van alles.
Vind het knap dat je het volhouden? Vind echt de prestatie?
Ja, het is soms doorbikkelen. En net als Bo zegt, het is ook wel echt een mentaal aspect. Waar je gewoon goed op een rijtje moet hebben, wil je dat doel bereiken.
Ja. I think Bo, that you need a captain who is good with the guys.
Yeah, well,
it's your right hand.
Yeah, that's, you know, we have the leadership group, and Mickey and a couple of the guys that have been here for all the years I've been here, and I think as far as the group, it's great. You know, it's a good group. They're great guys.
It's important.
Like I mentioned earlier, it's one of the things you don't get to use your dressing room the way you usually would, and the cohesive, it's not really there as normally it would be. You know, you'd be there before practice, everybody's talking about certain things, preparing for practice in a certain way. Now you kind of lost that part, and in hockey it's a big thing, you know. It's a big team sport, and it's a lot different sport than all the other team sports. I think, and if you look at the soccer and everything else, hockey's just a little different. It's a different mentality, and the guys much more of a group than a lot of the other sports.
It must be a great moment when you guys get together all in the same dressing room.
Yeah, that's before the games, after the games. In Germany, that's great. You know, I think has something to it. It's
What's your aim for the? Yeah, of course, if you also win the championship, but when you see after the pre, before you get into the playoffs, your aim, what do you think?
Yeah, right now, aim is to win the next game.
Yeah, and,
then the game after, I think, you know, for us, to where we're at now and with the situation we're at, I think, you know, if we'd like to finish in the top three for sure and before the playoffs, and then, you know, give it a good push in the playoffs. Make sure we get everything straightened out and, you know, get everything, ready for a good playoff run.
I hope you guys can play for your own fans pretty fast, that you get in your own
arena,
and that you can play your home games at home.
That's the thing, home ice advantage. At home we barely lost games over the last couple of years, and now we kind of lost that advantage. So that makes it a bit difficult. You know, we had the great fans.
Yeah, you're missing your seventh man.
Yep, that's
the thing.
That's true.
Yeah, that is okay. I want to thank you guys for joining me for the interview, and wish you all good luck, and Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, and all the best for the team. Thanks for coming.